Bartending for Fun and Profit, A Guide for Beginners. Introduction. So a guy walks into a bar and asks the bartender, "How many jokes have you heard start out that way?" The bartender is the main focus of any commercial bar. Forget about the waitresses. Sure, they bring the drinks, but the bartender has to make them. Forget about the fry cook serving up greasy fries. It's the bartender who has made you crave them. Bartenders have enjoyed a long and storied history. They are the psychiatrists that you don't have to have an appointment for. They are the ones you hear all the best jokes from. They are the ones who show you the neatest bar tricks to impress your friends. The bartender, for some people, is the best friend they never had. Tending bar is more than just pouring a cold draft beer or mixing up a mean screwdriver. With all the new drink combinations out these days, bartenders must be up on all the new terminology, not to mention having the ability to mix up an Alabama Slammer without looking in the recipe book. Bartending schools are popping up all over the country. Lured by the enticement of cash tips for serving the drunken public, bartending has been elevated to an art form. When the movie Cocktail came out, bartenders sought out the ability to twirl bottles and throw them up in the air as the bottle pours a perfect shot before it lands softly in their hand. Few can argue, this is something not the everyday Joe can do. Whether you aspire to the cocktail fame made popular by Tom Cruise, or if you just want to have an impressive home bar, this book will explore all aspects of tending bar. We'll tell you how to have a well-stocked home bar and a well-stocked commercial bar. We'll explain some of the terminology associated with partaking of alcoholic beverages and provide you with many of the most popular recipes requested on spring break or in your local pub. Better than that, we'll give you some pretty impressive bar tricks you can use and some cutting-edge jokes that will have your customers or friends rolling on the floor, and not just because they just did their 10th tequila shot. Bartending for Beginners will be everything you need and more. So let's get started in the bar business. The Professional Bartender. A bartender is someone who serves beverages behind a licensed bar to paying customers. A bartender can also be called a barkeep or a barmaid. Bartenders are found in bars, pubs, taverns, nightclubs, and other such places. The bartender mixes and serves drinks, and the majority of drinks a bartender is making contain alcohol, such as beer, wine, liquor, liqueur, coolers, and cocktails. They also serve water, juice, pop, and other non-alcoholic beverages for customers who do not wish to drink alcohol, such as a designated driver or a non-drinker. As well as make and serve drinks, the bartender is also responsible for taking payment for drinks, either from customers, waiters, or waitresses, keeping the liquor supplies and glassware stocked, keeping the bar area clean, maintaining enough ice and garnishes on hand, and serving food to customers sitting at the bar, if the bar offers food for sale. Often, the bartender is expected to dress appropriately to add to the atmosphere of the bar. In some establishments, the bartender might participate in flair bartending, which contributes to the entertainment in the bar. Bartenders are expected to be able to mix hundreds of types of drinks to please any paying customer in a quick, accurate, and non-wasteful fashion. In some establishments, such as a busy nightclub, the bartender is only expected to serve the customer a drink and nothing else. In a small place, such as a tavern, however, the bartender might be expected to be a good listener and allow the customers to have a shoulder to cry on. All bartenders should be friendly, however, and enjoy having contact and communication with customers. Good bartenders have a way of attracting regular customers. Good bartenders like this will remember the favored drinks of regular customers, have drink recommendations on hand or recommendations for other bars, as well as several other unofficial duties. In most countries, tipping is expected of the customer, and this is how the bartender gets the majority of his income, as most bartenders are paid minimum wage. In some places, minors are allowed in bars, and it's the bartender's responsibility to check for identification before serving them alcohol. If this sounds like a lot of work without much reward, look on the bright side. You are working at an establishment that serves gallons of liquor each day, and you are in charge of it. The job of bartender is management, customer service, and so much more. Even a bartending job looks good on a resume when you present it in the proper way. Before you start to tend bar, whether it's as a job or in your own home, a good grasp of liquor terms can be a great asset. Terminology. A lot of the terms and phrases listed below are standard throughout the industry. A good professional bartender will know his or her profession inside out. If you're just tending bar at home, you're sure to impress people with your vast knowledge. Here are some of the more common terms used in bartending. Box. Pour the drink into and out of a shaker, usually only once. This gives the drink a quick mixing without shaking. Call drink. A liquor and mixer, of which the liquor is a name brand, i.e. Tanqueray and Tonic, Bacardi and Coke, etc. Chaser. A chaser is a mixer that is consumed immediately after a straight shot of liquor to create a different taste. Cocktail. This can be any of various alcoholic beverages consisting usually of brandy, whiskey, vodka, or gin, combined with fruit juices or other liquors and often served chilled. Collins. A drink similar to a sour, which is served in a tall glass with soda water or seltzer water. Cooler. A drink consisting of ginger ale, soda water, and a fresh spiral or twist of citrus fruit rind and served in a Collins or highball glass. Crusta. A sour-type drink served in a glass that is completely lined with an orange or lemon peel cut in a continuous strip. Cup. A punch-type drink that is made up in quantities of cups or glasses in preference to a punch bowl. Daisy. An oversized drink of the sour type, normally made with rum or gin. It is served over crushed ice with a straw and sweetened with a fruit syrup. Lace. Normally applies to the last ingredient in a recipe, meaning to pour on top of the drink. Eggnog. A traditional holiday drink containing a combination of eggs beaten with cream or milk, sugar, and a liquor such as rum, brandy, or bourbon. Fix. A sour-type drink similar to the Daisy made with crushed ice in a large goblet. Fizz. An effervescent beverage, one which is carbonated and emits small bubbles. Flip. A chilled, creamy drink made of eggs, sugar, and a wine or spirit. Brandy and sherry flips are two of the better-known kinds of flips. Frappe. This is a partially frozen, often fruity drink. It is usually a mixture of ingredients served over a mound of crushed ice. Grog, a rum-based beverage with water, fruit juice, and sugar commonly served in a large mug. Highball, any spirit served with ice and soda in a medium to tall glass, a highball glass. Julep, a drink made of bourbon, mint, sugar, and crushed ice. Lowball, a short drink made of spirits served with ice, water, or soda in a small glass. Mist, a liquor served over a glass filled with crushed ice, often, as is the case, with an after-dinner drink. Mulls, a sweetened and spiced heated liquor, wine, or beer served as a hot punch. Neat, the consumption of a spirit as a straight, unaccompanied shot. Nip, a quarter of a bottle. Nightcap, wine or liquor often consumed right before bedtime. On the rocks, a drink served over ice. Pick-me-up. A drink designed to relieve the effects of overindulgence in alcohol. Punch. A party-sized beverage consisting of fruit, fruit juices, flavorings and sweeteners, soft drinks, and a wine or liquor base. Ricky. A drink made of a liquor, usually gin, a half lime, and soda water. It is sometimes sweetened and often served with ice. Shooter. A straight shot of liquor taken neat. Sling. A drink made with either brandy, whiskey, or gin, along with lemon juice, sugar, and soda water. It is served both hot and cold. Sour. A short drink consisting of liquor, lemon or lime juice, and sugar. Toddy. A sweetened drink of liquor and hot water, often with spices. Tot. A small amount of liquor. Virgin. A non-alcoholic drink. Well drink. A liquor and mixer of which neither are defined brands, i.e. gin and tonic, rum and coke. So we have the terminology down. Now let's look at what a well-stocked bar looks like. Stocking your bar. Stocking a commercial bar and stocking a home bar are probably going to be two entirely different things, unless you're willing to spend thousands of dollars on your home bar. If you are, by all means, follow our list to the letter. The liquor store will love you. First, we'll look at the typical commercial bar stock list. Stocking a commercial bar. You'll want to make sure you have all the necessary liquors, mixers, and garnishes to make your customers happy. If someone orders a slippery nipple and you don't have any butterscotch schnapps, you probably won't have a return customer. Although, it surely depends on how badly they want that shot. When it comes to liquors, here is a list of essentials. Gin, vodka, rum, light and dark, whiskey, bourbon, scotch, rye, Canadian, Irish cream, wine, white, dry, red, dry, champagne, vermouth, dry, sweet, tequila, brandy, cognac, beer. Fruits are important as garnishes. Having plenty of the right fruits on hand can also be important. Apples, bananas, cherries, lemons, limes, oranges, pineapples, strawberries. Fruit juices are used as mixers with the liquor to make various drinks. Plus, having them on hand for your non-drinking customers can be just as important. Apple, cranberry, grapefruit, lemon, lime, orange, pineapple, tomato. Making some of the more exotic drinks requires the mixing of liqueurs along with typical liquors and other additives to achieve the desired taste. Liqueurs can also be drunk on their own as shots or an after-dinner nip. Amaretto, almond, blue curacao, orange, chambord, raspberry, cointreau, orange, crème de banana, banana, crème de cacao, chocolate, crème de mint, mint, frangelico, hazelnut, galliano, herb, Godiva, chocolate, Goldschlager, cinnamon, Grand Marnier, orange, Jagermeister, herb, Kahlua, coffee, Maduri, melon, Rumpel mince, peppermint, Sambuca, anise, schnapps, various flavors, Southern Comfort, peach, Tia Maria, coffee, triple sec, orange. There are other mixers you must have on hand besides fruit juices. Many drinks utilize popular soft drinks and other non-conventional ingredients for the drinks. Angostura bitters, lemonade, cola, cream, eggs, ginger ale, grenadine, ice cream, milk, orange bitters, sour mix, Sprite 7-Up, tea, coffee, water, soda, tonic. Finally, you'll want to have plenty of garnishes around to make your drinks look appealing and taste yummy. Cinnamon, ice, maraschino cherries, nutmeg, olives, black and green, salt, pepper, sugar, sugar syrup, Tabasco sauce, Worcestershire sauce. Stocking a home bar. When stocking your home bar, you need to keep in mind how much entertaining you do and what types of drinks your friends and family like. Sure, it might be nice to be able to produce the ingredients for a flaming Dr. Pepper, but if you only have one crazy friend who might ask for that, the cost of the ingredients might just outweigh the need to have them on hand. What should the typical home bar have on hand? Well, besides a healthy supply of beer and wine, here's a nice list to start with. Gin, vodka, rum, whiskey, tequila, brandy, cognac. Fruits are important as garnishes. Having plenty of the right fruits on hand can also be important. Cherries, lemons, limes. Fruit juices are used as mixers with the liqueur to make various drinks. Plus, having them on hand for your non-drinking customers can be just as important. Apple, cranberry, orange, pineapple, tomato. Making some of the more exotic drinks requires the mixing of liqueurs along with typical liquors and other additives to achieve the desired taste. Liqueurs can also be drunk on their own as shots or an after-dinner nip. Amaretto, almond, crème de menthe, mint, Jagermeister, herb, Kahlua, coffee, schnapps, various flavors, triple sec, orange. There are other mixers you must have on hand besides fruit juices. Many drinks utilize popular soft drinks and other non-conventional ingredients for the drinks. Cola, ginger ale, grenadine, sour mix, Sprite, 7-Up, water, tonic, lemon and or lime juice. Finally, you'll want to have plenty of garnishes around to make your drinks look appealing and taste yummy. Ice, maraschino cherries, olives, black green, salt, pepper, sugar, Tabasco sauce, Worcestershire sauce. Of course, now that you have the ingredients, you'll need the appropriate tools to do the job. The various tools include glassware, so let's again see what you'll need for both a commercial and home bar. Tools of the trade. The last thing you want to have happen is to have someone want a bottle of beer and be lacking a bottle opener. At home or in a business, there are certain tools of the trade that are needed in all circumstances. Commercial supplies. Can opener, useful for opening cans of fruit and syrup. Corkscrew, for opening wine and champagne bottles. Cloths, used for wiping surfaces and equipment. These should be damp and not wet. Cutting board, for slicing fruit and other garnishes, should be heavy and laminated. Bar towels. These are 100% cotton and have sewn edges for durability. Use these along with cloths to keep things clean. Make good use of times when you have no guests to clean bottles and wipe surfaces. Bottle opener, for opening screw-top bottles. Bottle sealers, for keeping liquors and other bottle contents fresh. Cocktail shaker. A shaker is essential for blending ingredients in cocktails and mixed drinks. There are many cocktail shakers available. Most get the job done. Choose one that's right for you. Electric blender. Many cocktails require a blender to blend the ingredients smoothly together. These prove very useful for drinks with fruit pieces or ice cream, etc. Grater. To grate spices, like nutmeg. Ice bucket. A metal or insulated ice bucket keeps your ice cold and clean. Ice tongs and scoops. Use these to add ice to drinks without the risk of passing on unwanted germs. Never handle ice with your hands. Do not use glassware as a scoop, lest it breaks or chips and leaves unwanted visitors in your drinks. Jigger shot glass, used as a measurement tool. Juice squeezer extractor. This is needed for getting the most juice out of your fruits. It helps to soak citrus fruit in hot water before squeezing. Bar spoon. A bar spoon has a long handle and a muddler end that will allow you to mix and measure ingredients as well as crush garnishes. Measuring cups. Normally, these should be glass or chrome with incremented measurements imprinted up the side. These are needed for accurate measurement. They usually come with a set of measuring spoons, which are needed for some smaller quantities. Mixing glass. A mixing glass is useful for long drinks where it is required to mix the ingredients without shaking. Sharp knife, for cutting fruit and garnishes. Strainer. This removes the ice and fruit pulp from juices. This may come with a cocktail shaker. Glasses and containers. There are various types of glassware of different shapes and sizes, all serving their own purpose. Learning which drinks belong to which glass is beneficial to both you and your customers. They receive a higher quality drink, which in turn reflects back on you and your establishment. Ensure all glassware is cleaned spotless prior to serving it to your customers. Wash glasses with warm water and a small amount of detergent, but not soap. Rinse them afterwards with fresh cold water and polish them with a suitable cloth. Hold glasses by the base or stem of the glass to avoid fingerprints. Following are all the glasses you need in a commercial bar. Beer mug. A traditional beer container, typically 16 ounces. Brandy snifter. The shape of this glass concentrates the alcohol odors to the top of the glass as your hands warm the brandy. Typical size, 17.5 ounces. Champagne flute. A tulip-shaped glass designed to show off the bubbles of the wine as they brush against the side of the glass and spread out in a sparkling pattern. Typically, 6 ounces. Cocktail glass. This glass has a triangle bowl design with a long stem and is used for a wide range of straight-up, without-ice cocktails, including martinis, Manhattans, Metropolitans, and gimlets. It is also known as a martini glass. Typical size, 4 to 12 ounces. Coffee mug. Traditional mug used for hot coffee, typically 12 to 16 ounces. Collins glass, shaped similarly to a highball glass, only taller. The Collins glass was originally used for the line of Collins gin drinks and is now also commonly used for soft drinks, alcoholic juice, and tropical exotic juices such as Mai Tais. Typical size, 14 ounces. Cordial glass, small and stemmed glasses used for serving small portions of your favorite liquors after a meal. Typically, 2 ounces. Highball glass. A straight-sided glass, often an elegant way to serve many types of mixed drinks, like those served on the rocks, shots, and mixers combined with liquor drinks, i.e. gin and tonic. Typical size, 8 to 12 ounces. Hurricane glass. A tall, elegantly cut glass, named after its hurricane lamp-like shape, and used for exotic or tropical drinks. 15 ounces. Margarita cupid glass. This slightly larger and rounded approach to a cocktail glass has a broad rim for holding salt, ideal for margaritas. It is also used in daiquiris and other fruit drinks. Typical size, 12 ounces. Mason jar. These are large, square containers and are effective in keeping their contents sealed in an airtight environment. Typically, these are used for home canning and are about 16 ounces. Old-fashioned glass. A short, round, so-called rocks glass, suitable for cocktails or liquor served on the rocks or with a splash. Typical size, 8 to 10 ounces. Parfait glass. This glass has a similar inward curve to that of a hurricane glass, but with a steeper outwards rim and a larger rounded bowl. These are often used for drinks containing fruit or ice cream. 12 ounces. Pouss Café glass. A narrow glass essentially used for Pouss Cafés and other layered dessert drinks. Its shape increases the ease of layering ingredients. The typical size is 6 ounces. Punch bowl. A large spherical bowl used for punches or large mixes, 1 to 5 gallons. Red wine glass. A clear, thin, stemmed glass with a round bowl tapering inward at the rim. Typical size, 8 ounces. Sherry glass. This is the preferred glass for aperitifs, ports, and sherry. This has a narrow taper and is usually around 2 ounces. Shot glass. A shot glass is a small glass suitable for vodka, whiskey, and other liquors. Many shot mixed drinks also call for shot glasses. Typical size, 1.5 ounces. Whiskey sour glass. This type of glass is also known as a Delmonico glass. It has a stemmed wide opening similar to a champagne flute and holds about 5 ounces. White wine glass. A clear, thin, stemmed glass with an elongated oval bowl tapering inward at the rim. Typical size, 12.5 ounces. Home bar. Stocking tools for a home bar will require much fewer supplies, but there are a few staples you will definitely want to have. Can opener. Useful for opening cans of fruit juices. Corkscrew. For opening wine and champagne bottles. Cloths. For wiping surfaces and equipment. These should be damp and not wet. Cutting board. A heavy, laminated cutting board is best for slicing fruit and other garnishes. Bottle opener. For opening screw-top bottles. Cocktail shaker. This is used for blending ingredients in cocktails and mixed drinks. Electric blender. Many cocktails require a blender to blend the ingredients smoothly together. This is useful for drinks with fruit pieces or ice cream, etc. Ice bucket. A metal or insulated ice bucket keeps your ice cold and clean. Ice tongs and scoops. Tongs are used to add ice to drinks. Jigger shot glass. This is used as a measurement tool. Sharp knife. For cutting fruit and garnishes. Glass and containers. Beer mug. 16 ounces. Traditional beer container. Champagne flute. 6 ounces. Tulip-shaped glass designed to show off the bubbles from the champagne. Cocktail glass. This glass has a triangle bowl design with a long stem and is used for a wide range of straight-up, without-ice cocktails, including martinis, Manhattans, Metropolitans, and gimlets, also known as a martini glass. Typical size, 4 to 12 ounces. Collins glass. Shaped similarly to a highball glass, only taller. The Collins glass was originally used for the line of Collins gin drinks and is now also commonly used for soft drinks, alcoholic juice, and tropical exotic juices, such as Mai Tais. Typical size, 14 ounces. Highball glass. A straight-sided glass, often an elegant way to serve many types of mixed drinks, like those served on the rocks, shots, and mixer-combined liquor drinks, i.e. gin and tonic. Typical size, 8 to 12 ounces. Hurricane glass. This is a tall glass with a hurricane lamp shape used for exotic or tropical drinks. Margarita Cupid glass. This slightly larger and rounded approach to a cocktail glass has a broad rim for holding salt, ideal for margaritas. It is also used in daiquiris and other fruit drinks. Typical size, 12 ounces. Old-fashioned glass. A short, round, so-called rocks glass, suitable for cocktails or liquors served on the rocks or with a splash. Typical size, 8 to 10 ounces. Red wine glass. A clear, thin, stemmed glass with a round bowl tapering inward at the rim. Typical size, 8 ounces. Shot glass. This is a small glass suitable for vodka, whiskey, and other liquors. Many shot mixed drinks also call for shot glasses. Typical size, 1.5 ounces. Whether you are at home or at work, it's essential to master some of the basic techniques of bartending before you start. Basic techniques. Creating cocktails can be straightforward or artistic, depending on the person, their tastes, and how far they want to take it. Often, the first lesson of bartending school teaches the basic skills from shaking to pouring over a spoon. Most people can easily get by with these techniques in a professional situation. When tending bar at home, it's a definite. Shaking. Shaking is the method by which you use a cocktail shaker to mix ingredients together and chill them simultaneously. The object is to almost freeze the drink while breaking down and combining the ingredients. Normally, this is done with ice cubes added to the shaker about 3/4 of the way to the top. Then pour in the ingredients. Hold the shaker in both hands with one hand on top and one hand supporting the base. Give the shaker a short, sharp, snappy shake. Do not rock your cocktail to sleep. When water has begun to condense on the surface of the shaker, the cocktail is chilled and ready to be strained. Straining. Most cocktail shakers are sold with a built-in strainer or Hawthorne strainer. When a drink calls for straining, ensure you've used ice cubes, as crushed ice tends to clog the strainer of a standard shaker. If a drink is required shaken with crushed ice, i.e. Shirley Temple, it is to be served unstrained. Stirring. You can stir cocktails effectively with a metal or glass rod in a mixing glass. If you use ice, use them to prevent dilution and strain the contents into a glass when the surface of the mixing glass begins to collect condensation. Muddling. To extract the most flavor from certain fresh ingredients such as fruit or mint garnishes, you should crush the ingredient with the muddler on the back end of your bar spoon or with a pestle. Blending. An electric blender is often needed for recipes containing fruit or other ingredients that do not break down by shaking. Blending is a great way to combine these ingredients with others, creating a smooth, ready-to-serve mixture. Some recipes call for ice to be placed in the blender, in which case you would use a suitable amount of crushed ice to produce a smooth, pleasant-tasting drink. Building. When building a cocktail, the ingredients are poured into the glass in which the cocktail will be served. Usually, the ingredients are floated on top of each other, but occasionally, a swizzle stick is put in the glass, allowing the ingredients to be mixed. Layering. To layer or float an ingredient such as cream liquor on top of another, use the rounded back part of a spoon and rest it against the inside of a glass. Slowly pour the liquor down the spoon and into the glass. The ingredient should run down the inside of the glass and remain separated from the ingredient below it. Flaming. Flaming is the method by which a cocktail or liquor is set alight, normally to enhance the flavor of a drink. It should only be attempted with caution, and for the above reason only, not to simply look cool. Some liquor will ignite quite easily if their proof is high. Heating a small amount of liquor in a spoon will cause the alcohol to collect at the top, which can then be easily lit. You can then pour this over the prepared ingredients. Don't add alcohol to ignited drinks, and don't leave them unattended. Light them where they pose no danger to anybody else, and ensure no objects can possibly come into contact with any flames from the drink. Always extinguish a flaming drink before consuming it. There is nothing more depressing than a fro-fro drink that has no decoration to it. Here are some of the more popular decoration techniques. Decorating your cocktails. Decoration of a drink will normally consist of one or two fruit, herb, or cherry garnishes that either complement the flavor of the drink, contrast with the color, or both. It is important that you avoid overpowering the drink. When garnishing with fruit, be careful with the size. If it is too thin, it's flimsy and uneventful. A too thick slice can unbalance the look and even flavor of the cocktail. Citrus twists. To make a citrus twist, cut a thin slice of the fruit crosswise and simply twist to serve on the side of a glass or in it. Citrus peel spirals. To make a spiral of citrus peel, use a parer or vegetable peeler to cut away the skin, working in a circular motion. Take care not to cut into the bitter pith. Citrus peel knots. Use strips of peel and carefully tie each strip into a knot. Drop into a drink for a nice garnish. Cocktail sticks. These extremely useful wooden cocktail sticks are needed for spearing through pieces of fruit and cherries. These are not reusable. Plastic cocktail sticks, however, are reusable provided they are washed and boiled. Frosting, rimming. Margaritas and other mixed drinks often call for the rim of the glass to be coated with salt, sugar, or some other ingredient. This is known as frosting or rimming. The easiest way to do this is to rub the rim of the glass with a slice of citrus fruit and then dip the very edge of the rim into a small bowl filled with the sugar or salt. Maraschino cherries. You should always have a plentiful supply of red maraschino cherries to decorate your cocktails with. These are the most widely used of decorations, as well as being available in multiple colors and flavors. Olives or onions. Martinis are often garnished with olives or cocktail onions. Simply skewer one or two with a toothpick and drop into the drink. Straws. Straws are essential and go well with many cocktails. These, of course, should never be reused. Before we move on to the good part, recipes, we need to address the issue of bar safety and hygiene. Hygiene and safety. Here are a few guidelines to remember regarding hygiene and safety in a bar, whether it be at home or at work. While most of these suggestions might be common sense, they bear notation in this book for the safety of you, your guests, and or your customers. Always be tidy, clean, and diplomatic. Always rinse or wash bar equipment like cocktail shakers and strainers after every use, even between drinks. Always wash and dry your hands frequently, especially after contact with citrus fruit and juices. This helps prevent scaling of the hands and infection from dermatitis. Take good care of your hands, especially your fingernails, as these are always in view. Keep nails short. If you use nail polish, use neutral colors so the focus is on you and your creations instead of your fingernails. In general, it is frowned upon to smoke or drink while working behind a bar. Many people view it as unsanitary. In some places, it is also illegal. When uncorking champagne, try to prevent the pop of the cork. While this is usually associated with champagne, it can be a dangerous practice if the cork should become errant. When using a soda siphon, handle it by the plastic or metal part only. This is the most sanitary way to approach pouring a soda. Never fill a glass to the brim. This encourages spilling and makes the entire bar unsanitary and messy. Now, let's look at some of the more common drink recipes. Drink recipes. There are a myriad of drinks out there concocted in someone's basement or kitchen when there were just a few drops of liquor left and some type of mixer. Others have been created by bored bartenders who thought certain combinations might taste good together. Still, others are staples that are ordered nearly every day in a bar. We can't include all drink recipes, but here are some of the most popular ones. Alabama Slammer. 1/2 ounce Amaretto Almond Liqueur. 1/2 ounce Southern Comfort Peach Liqueur. 1/2 ounce Slow Gin. 1 splash Orange Juice. 1 splash Sweet and Sour Mix. Pour above ingredients into a stainless steel shaker over ice and shake until completely cold. Strain into an old-fashioned glass and serve. Amaretto Sour. 1 1/2 ounce Amaretto Almond Liqueur. 1 to 2 splashes Sweet and Sour Mix. Pour the Amaretto liqueur into a cocktail shaker, half filled with ice cubes. Add a splash or two of Sweet and Sour Mix and shake well. Strain or pour into an old-fashioned glass. Garnish with a maraschino cherry and a slice of orange and serve. Brandy Alexander. 1 1/2 ounce Brandy. 1 ounce Creme de Cacao. 1 ounce Half and Half. 1/4 teaspoon grated nutmeg. In a shaker half filled with ice cubes, combine the brandy, creme de cacao, and half and half. Shake well. Strain into a cocktail glass and garnish with the nutmeg. Bloody Mary. 1 1/2 ounce vodka. 3 ounces tomato juice. 1 dash lemon juice. 1/2 teaspoon Worcestershire sauce. 2 to 3 drops Tabasco sauce. 1 lime wedge. Shake all ingredients except lime wedge with ice and strain into an old-fashioned glass over ice cubes. Add salt and pepper to taste. Add the wedge of lime and serve. Blue Hawaiian. 1 ounce light rum. 1 cherry. 2 ounces pineapple juice. 1 ounce blue curacao liqueur. 1 ounce cream of coconut. 1 slice pineapple. Blend light rum, blue curacao, pineapple juice, and cream of coconut with 1 cup ice in an electric blender at high speed. Pour contents into a highball glass. Decorate with a slice of pineapple and a cherry. Cosmopolitan. 1 ounce vodka. 1/2 ounce triple sec. 1/2 ounce lime juice. 1/2 ounce cranberry juice. Shake vodka, triple sec, lime, and cranberry juice vigorously in a shaker with ice. Strain into a martini glass. Garnish with a lime wedge on the rim and serve. Fuzzy Navel. 1 part peach schnapps. 1 part orange juice. 1 part lemonade. Mix equal parts of each ingredient into a highball glass, top with ice, and serve. Gibson. 1 1/2 ounce gin. 3/4 ounces vermouth. 2 cocktail onions. Stir gin and vermouth over ice cubes in a mixing glass. strain into a cocktail glass, add the cocktail onions, and serve. Gimlet. 2 ounces gin. 1/2 ounce lime juice. 1 lime wedge. Pour the gin and lime juice into a mixing glass half filled with ice cubes. Stir well. Strain into a cocktail glass and garnish with lime wedge. Harvey Wallbanger. 1 ounce vodka. 1/2 ounce Galliano herbal liquor. 4 ounces orange juice. Pour vodka and orange juice into a Collins glass over ice cubes and stir. Float Galliano on top and serve. Kamikaze. 1 ounce vodka. 1 ounce triple sec. 1 ounce lime juice. Shake all ingredients with ice, strain into an old-fashioned glass over ice cubes, and serve. Lemon drop. 1/2 ounce vodka. 1/2 ounce lemon juice. 1 sugar cube. Add sugar to the rim of an old-fashioned glass and drop a cube or packet of sugar into the bottom of the glass. Pour vodka and lemon juice into a stainless steel shaker over ice and shake until completely cold. Pour into the prepared old-fashioned glass and serve. Long Island Iced Tea. 1 part vodka. 1 part tequila. 1 part rum. 1 part gin. 1 part triple sec. 1 1/2 parts sweet and sour mix. 1 splash cola. Mix ingredients together over ice in a glass. Pour into a shaker and give 1 brisk shake. Pour back into the glass and make sure there is a touch of fizz at the top. Garnish with lemon. Mai Tai. 1 ounce light rum. 1/2 ounce creme d'almond. 1/2 ounce triple sec. Sweet and sour mix. Pineapple juice. 1/2 ounce Meyer's dark rum. Pour light rum, creme d'almond, and triple sec, in order, into a Collins glass. Almost fill with equal parts of sweet and sour mix and pineapple juice. Add dark rum, a large straw, and serve unstirred. Margarita. 1 1/2 ounce tequila. 1/2 ounce triple sec. 1 ounce lime juice. Salt. Rub the rim of a cocktail glass with lime juice and dip in salt. Shake all ingredients with ice, strain into the glass, and serve. Mojito. 3 fresh mint sprigs. 2 teaspoons sugar. 3 tablespoons fresh lime juice. 1 1/2 ounce light rum. Club soda. In a tall, thin glass, crush part of the mint with a fork to coat the inside. Add the sugar and lime juice and stir thoroughly. Top with ice. Add rum and mix. Top off with chilled club soda or seltzer. Add a lemon slice and the remaining mint, and serve. Mudslide. 1 1/2 ounce Bailey's Irish Cream. 1/2 ounce Kahlua coffee liqueur. Pour Hershey's chocolate syrup around the inside rim of a rocks glass. Fill with ice, add ingredients, and serve. Old Fashioned. 2 ounces blended whiskey. 1 sugar cube. 1 dash bitters. 1 slice lemon. 1 cherry. 1 slice orange. Combine the sugar cube, bitters, and 1 teaspoon water in an old-fashioned glass. Muddle well. Add blended whiskey and stir. Add a twist of lemon peel and ice cubes. Add slices of orange and lemon and top with the cherry. Serve with a swizzle stick. Pina Colada. 3 ounces light rum. 3 tablespoons coconut milk. 3 tablespoons crushed pineapples. Put all ingredients into an electric blender with 2 cups of crushed ice. Blend at a high speed for a short length of time. Strain into a Collins glass and serve with a straw. Rob Roy. 1 1/2 ounce Scotch whiskey. 3/4 ounce sweet vermouth. Stir ingredients with ice, strain into a cocktail glass, and serve. Salty Dog. 5 ounces grapefruit juice. 1 1/2 ounce gin. 1/4 teaspoon salt. Pour all ingredients over ice cubes in a highball glass. Stir well and serve. Vodka may be substituted for gin if preferred. Sea Breeze. 1 1/2 ounce vodka. 4 ounces cranberry juice. 1 ounce grapefruit juice. Pour vodka over ice into a highball glass. Add mixers. The drink may be garnished with a wedge of lime. Sex on the Beach. 1 ounce vodka. 3/4 ounce peach snaps. Cranberry juice. Grapefruit juice. Add vodka and peach snaps into a highball glass. Fill with equal measures of cranberry juice and grapefruit juice and stir. slow, comfortable screw, 3 ounces slow gin, 3 ounces Southern Comfort peach liqueur, 3 ounces orange juice, 3 ounces vodka. Stir or shake ingredients and serve with ice. Strawberry daiquiri, 1/2 ounce strawberry schnapps, 1 ounce light rum, 1 ounce lime juice, 1 teaspoon powdered sugar, 1 ounce strawberries. Shake all ingredients with ice, strain into a cocktail glass, and serve. Tequila Sunrise, 1 shot tequila, orange juice, 2 dashes grenadine syrup. Pour tequila in a highball glass with ice and top with orange juice. Stir. Add grenadine by tilting glass and pouring grenadine downside by flipping the bottle vertically very quickly. The grenadine should go straight to the bottom and then rise slowly through the drink. Garnish stirrer, straw, and cherry orange. Tom Collins, 2 ounces gin, 1 ounce lemon juice, 1 teaspoon superfine sugar, 3 ounces club soda, 1 maraschino cherry, 1 slice orange. In a shaker, half filled with ice cubes, combine the gin, lemon juice, and sugar. Shake well. Strain into a Collins glass almost filled with ice cubes. Add the club soda. Stir and garnish with the cherry and the orange slice. Whiskey Sour, 2 ounces blended whiskey, juice of half lemons, 1 teaspoon powdered sugar, 1 cherry, half sliced lemon. Shake blended whiskey, juice of lemon, and powdered sugar with ice and strain into a whiskey sour glass. Decorate with a half slice of lemon, top with the cherry, and serve. The trend toward martini drinking is becoming increasingly popular. Want some killer martini recipes? That's our next section. Martinis galore. Standard gin martini. Many contend that the gin martini is the only mix fitting to wear the name martini, and all other cocktails are imposters. Ingredients: 6 ounces of gin, 5 drops of dry vermouth, 2 small twists of lemon rind, 2 olives. The mix: fill a glass martini shaker about 3/4 full of cracked, clean ice. Pour your gin into the shaker and let stand for 60 seconds. Count down from 60 to 0. Shake, shake, and shake. About 15 vigorous diagonal shakes should do the trick. Put that shaker down and get 2 well-chilled martini glasses from the fridge or freezer. Allow the shaker to rest for about another 60 seconds. Into each glass, drop 2 drops of vermouth. The 5th drop is just for good luck. Each glass gets a twist and an olive. The olive can be optional. Strain your very chilly gin into each glass. Standard Vodka Martini. Although this martini will certainly qualify as a standard martini, you'll often find that every bartender will create the drink with a slight, or perhaps not so slight, variation. Ingredients: 3 ounces of vodka, 1 teaspoon vermouth, 3 olives. The mix: pour your vodka into a well-chilled shaker and let stand for 60 seconds. Count down from 60 to 0. While counting down, drop your vermouth into a frozen martini glass. Swirl the vermouth around the glass and then pour it out. Shake, shake, and shake. About 15 vigorous diagonal shakes, followed by swirling the shaker a few times. Strain your freezing vodka into your glass. Spear your olives and gently slide them into the glass. Chocolate Martini. 1 1/2 shots chocolate liqueur. 1 1/2 shots creme de cacao. 1/2 shot vodka. 2 1/2 shots, half and half. Mix all ingredients in a shaker with ice. Shake and pour into a chilled cocktail glass. Apple Martini. 1 part vodka. 1 part De Kuyper Sour Apple Pucker Schnapps. 1 part apple juice. Pour all ingredients into a shaker. Shake well and strain into a martini glass. Dry Martini. Ingredients: 6 ounces of vodka, 1 teaspoon of vermouth, 6 olives, toasted almond slivers. The mix: pour your vodka into a well-chilled shaker and let stand for 30 seconds. While counting down, drop your vermouth into 2 frozen martini glasses. Swirl the vermouth around the glasses and then pour it out. Shake, shake, and shake. About 20 vigorous diagonal shakes, followed by swirling the shaker a few times. Strain your freezing vodka into your glasses. Insert an almond sliver into each stuffed olive and spear 3 per toothpick. Spear your olives and gently slide them into the glass. Lemon Martini. Ingredients: 4 ounces of vodka, 1/2 teaspoon of dry vermouth, 1 lemon twist, 1 thin lemon slice, 1 teaspoon limoncello. The mix. Rim your frozen martini glass with lemon twist cocktail candy and place back in the freezer until called for. Pour your vodka, vermouth, and limoncello into a shaker 3/4 full of ice. 20 energetic shakes. No stirring option on this one. Should mix it nicely. Retrieve your martini glass and strain the mixture into it. Slit your lemon slice halfway and slip it onto the rim of the glass. Add your lemon twist. The Boardroom Smoky Martini. Ingredients: 1/2 ounce dry vermouth, 4 ounces of gin, 2 tablespoons scotch, 10-year-old is preferred, you can experiment with any good single malt scotch, 2 lemon twists. The mix. Pour your vermouth and gin into a shaker half full of cracked ice. Shake, shake, and shake for a full minute. You may also stir for a full 2 minutes. Add your scotch and stir 4 times in a counterclockwise motion. Strain your smoky-flavored martini into 2 well-chilled martini glasses. Each glass gets a twist. Hey Sweetie Martini. This is a very sweet martini. This is a great alternative for a Cosmo lover, such as the person you'll be impressing with this simple-to-mix martini. Ingredients: 7 ounces of freezing vodka, 1 ounce of room-temperature Chambord, 1 teaspoon of honey. The mix. Warm your honey slightly and stir it into your Chambord. Pour your vodka into a shaker 3/4 full of cracked ice. Shake, shake, and shake it, baby. Add your honey-infused Chambord and stir 3 times. Strain your liquid into 2 freezing martini glasses. Key Lime Martini. Ingredients: 4 ounces key lime vodka, 2 ounces vodka, 2 tablespoons of fresh lime juice, 1 tablespoon of Cool Whip, 2 martini glasses rimmed with lime cocktail candy sugar, 2 super thin slices of lime. The mix. All of your vodka and 1 tablespoon of Cool Whip goes into a shaker that is 3/4 full of cracked ice. Shake for a good minute. Let your shaker rest for a 1/2 minute. Add 1 tablespoon of the lime juice to the shaker and give another 10 shakes. Strain into your 2 freezing martini glasses. Add 1/2 of the remaining lime juice to each glass and top each with a bit of the remaining Cool Whip. Float a lime slice on each glass. Valentine Martini. Ingredients: 5 ounces of freezing Chopin vodka, 5 ounces of chilled ice wine, 11 green seedless grapes at room temperature, 1 tablespoon of fresh lemon juice, 2 frozen green grapes. The mix. Add all of your liquid ingredients to a blender or food processor and puree. Strain into a cocktail shaker half full of cracked ice. Shake for a full minute. Strain your amazing martini into 2 freezing cocktail glasses. For those of you who are shot connoisseurs, we have included a separate section that follows with some basic shot recipes. Hit me, Sergeant! Shots are more than just a pour of liquor into a shot glass. These days, shots have been elevated to an art form. We are listing some of the more popular ones. B-52, 1/3 shot Kahlua coffee liqueur, 1/3 shot Amaretto almond liqueur, 1/3 shot Bailey's Irish cream. Carefully layer ingredients, in order, into a shot glass: Kahlua, Amaretto, then Irish cream. Blowjob: 1/4 ounce Bailey's Irish cream, 1/2 ounce Amaretto almond liqueur. Pour liqueurs into a shot glass and top with whipped cream. Have an individual place their hands behind their back, then pick up the filled shot glasses with their mouth, tilt head back, and drink. Body shots: 1/2 ounce vodka, 1 package sugar, 1 lemon wedge. Using a partner of the opposite sex, lick their neck to moisten. Pour a packet of sugar onto their neck. Place wedge of lemon in their mouth with the skin pointed inward. You first lick the sugar from their neck, then shoot the vodka, then suck the lemon from their mouth while gently holding back of their neck. Buttery nipple: 1/2 ounce De Kuyper Buttershots liqueur, 1/2 ounce Irish cream. Pour buttershots into a chilled shot glass. Carefully layer or float the Irish cream on top and serve. Chocolate cake: Half ounce Frangelico hazelnut liqueur. Half ounce vodka. Sugar. Add vodka and Frangelico to a shaker with ice. Shake. Garnish with a sugar-coated lemon. Shoot the drink like you would tequila. Flaming Dr. Pepper. 3/4 shot Amaretto almond liqueur. 1/4 ounce 151 proof rum. Half glass beer. Fill a shot glass about 3/4 full with Amaretto and top it off with enough 151 proof rum to be able to burn. Place the shot glass in another glass and fill the outer glass with beer right up to the level of the shot glass. Ignite the Amaretto 151 and let it burn for a while. Blow it out, or leave it burning if you're brave, not recommended, and slam it. Tastes just like Dr. Pepper. Jager Bomb. 1 can Red Bull energy drink. 1 ounce Jagermeister Herbal Bomb. Pour Red Bull into a pint glass, drop in a shot glass filled with Jagermeister, and chug. Jello Shots. 1 package Watermelon Jello. 1 cup boiling water. 1 cup Malibu Coconut Rum. Mix hot water and Jello. Add rum. Pour into 2-ounce cups. Serve after the Jello has set. Kamikaze. 1 part vodka. 1 part triple sec. 1 part Rose's lime juice. Shake well with ice and strain mixture into a shot glass. Salute. Liquid Cocaine. 1/2 ounce Bacardi 151 rum. 1/2 ounce Goldschlager cinnamon snaps. 1/2 ounce Jagermeister herbal liqueur. Pour ingredients as listed above into a large shot glass and shoot. Purple Hooter. 1/2 ounce vodka. 1/2 ounce Chambord raspberry liqueur. 1 splash 7-Up soda. Pour ingredients into a stainless steel shaker over ice. Shake until ice cold. Strain into a large shot glass and serve. Red-Headed Slut. 1 ounce peach snaps. 1 ounce Jagermeister herbal liqueur. Cranberry juice. Chill and serve. Scooby Snack. 1/2 ounce Malibu coconut rum. 1/2 ounce creme de bananas. 1/2 ounce Midori melon liqueur. 1/2 ounce pineapple juice. 1 1/2 ounce whipped cream. Pour rum, creme de banana, melon liqueur, and pineapple juice into a stainless steel shaker over ice. Add whipped cream and shake until well mixed and sufficiently chilled. Strain into an old-fashioned glass and shoot. Surfer on Acid. 1/2 ounce Jagermeister herbal liqueur. 1/2 ounce Malibu coconut rum. 1/2 ounce pineapple juice. Pour ingredients into a stainless steel shaker over ice and shake until completely cold. Strain into a large shot or old-fashioned glass and shoot. There are so many drink recipes out there, space prevents me from including them all. You can find nearly every single recipe you need at drinksmixer.com. These would include the brain fart, the ball sweat, the broken down golf cart, the flaming Bob Marley, finger me good, jet fuel, screaming orgasm, sit on my face, and tonsil tickler, among others. Being a great bartender, though, is so much more than just mixing great drinks. You have to hone your personality and give the people something to talk about. How about a few cool bar tricks? Bar tricks. Bar trick number 1. Olive and brandy snifter. Ingredients. 1 olive and 1 brandy snifter. Objective. Put olive in brandy snifter. Situation. You cannot touch the olive with your body, hands, mouth, etc. You cannot scoop the olive with the snifter. You cannot roll olive off bar into snifter. Solution. With the olive on the bar, place the brandy snifter over the olive so that the open end of the snifter is surrounding the olive. Slowly rotate the brandy snifter around the olive. The olive will roll around the inside walls of the snifter. Centrifugal force. Once the olive is spinning around the middle of the snifter, flip the snifter upright and place on the bar. Collect your winnings. Hints. Practice this trick before placing any bets. The olive has a tendency to come out of the snifter when flipping upright. After a little practice, you will be a pro. Submitted by Brick. Bar trick number 2. Embarrass your friends. Ingredients. 1 bar napkin and 1 pen pencil. Objective. Embarrass your friends and others. Situation. On a bar napkin, write down the following. I am we taught it. I am sofa king we taught it. Ask your friends to continue reading out loud until they understand. Continue to find new victims. Added bonus. Old victims will laugh at new victims. Bar trick number 3. The race. Ingredients. 3 shots of and 3 pints of beer. Objective: get a free round of drinks. Situation: tell your victim that you will drink your 3 pints of beer faster than they can drink their 3 small shots of... Player's rules: you cannot touch the other player's glass or shot. Solution: start drinking your beer. Your victim will take their first shot. As soon as you finish drinking your first beer, place your empty pint over your victim's 3rd shot. Take your time and enjoy your free drinks. Your victim cannot touch your glass. See above rule. You win. Bar trick number 4. The old 2 quarters trick. Ingredients: 2 quarters and 1 victim. Objective: to get a free drink. Situation: on the bar, place 2 quarters heads up. Ask your victim, what do you see? The usual answer is 2 heads or 2 quarters. Slowly start nodding your head in agreement, and with your palm up, point to the 2 quarters and say, I see 2 pennies. Hey, if I'm wrong, will you buy me a drink? Pressure them for a reply. Most people will say sure. At this point, say, I'm wrong. Enjoy your free drink. Added bonus: when drink is empty, find a new victim. Bar trick number 5. The 50-cent drink. Ingredients: 1 victim with a fresh drink, 1 cocktail napkin, 2 quarters. Objective: to get a cheap drink. Situation: taking victim's drink and remove any straws or umbrellas. Cover victim's drink with a cocktail napkin. Tell your victim, I bet you 50 cents that without touching the glass or the napkin or any straws, etc., I can drink that entire drink. Push the 2 quarters towards the victim while betting. Point to the glass and the napkin. Continue to say, I won't touch anything. Bring up the point about possibly putting a straw through the napkin and say, I won't touch anything. Solution: when they give up, slowly take off the napkin and enjoy the drink as you push the 50 cents to the victim. Be sure to tell the victim they won and give them their 50 cents. The $4 drink just cost you 50 cents. Enjoy your cheap drink. Bar trick number 6. Salt and pepper. Ingredients: 1 victim, 1 salt packet, 1 pepper packet, and 1 small plastic comb. Objective: to get a free drink. Situation: make a small hill of salt on the bar, about the size of a quarter. Then sprinkle a small amount of pepper on top of the salt. Bet your victim 1 drink that they cannot get the pepper off without disturbing the salt. Solution: take your plastic comb and comb your hair a few times. Then hold the comb over the salt and pepper. The static electricity will suck the pepper off the salt. Note: this trick will only work when the humidity levels are low. Bar trick number 7. Sugar cubes. Ingredients: 1 victim, 2 sugar cubes, 1 lighter, and 1 ashtray. Objective: to get a free drink. Situation: hand someone a sugar cube and a lighter. Bet them a drink that they cannot light the sugar cube on fire. They will try to light it on fire by putting the flame under it. They will get the cube to smoke, char, and smolder, but it will not catch on fire. Solution: rub your sugar cube in an ashtray to get some ashes on it. Hold the flame to the sugar cube. It should light right up. Note: practice this a few times before you start placing bets. Bar trick number 8. Ice cubes. Ingredients: 1 victim, 2 ice cubes, some salt, and 2 pieces of human hair about 6 to 8 inches long. Objective: to get a free drink. Situation: bet someone they cannot pick up an ice cube with 1 piece of human hair. The average person will try to twist and tie the hair around the ice cube. Others will try to just lift it up. However, they will not be able to get the ice cube off the bar. Solution: place the ice cube on the bar. Take a strand of human hair and place it across the top of the ice cube. Then, take a little salt and sprinkle it on top of the hair and ice cube. The salt will cause the ice cube to refreeze around the hair. In a few seconds, you will be able to gently lift the ice cube off the bar. Note: practice this a few times before you start placing bets. Bar trick number 9. The switch. Ingredients: 2 identical shot glasses, 1 non-porous piece of paper, playing card, oversized matchbook, etc., water, and your choice of alcohol, bourbon, scotch, etc. Objective: challenge your friends. Situation? Fill one shot glass with water and the other with, let's say, bourbon. The challenge is to get the bourbon in the glass that has the water and the water in the glass that has the bourbon without using any other containers, including your mouth or anyone else's mouth. Solution? Place the non-porous piece of paper, playing card, on top of the shot of water. Turn the card and water shot upside down carefully. The paper will stay attached to the shot on its own accord. Now, place the water shot glass and card on the shot of bourbon. Slowly and carefully pull the paper out just far enough to make a very small opening between the two glasses. Water, being heavier than alcohol, will flow to the bourbon glass and displace the bourbon into the water glass. You have just made the switch. If you are truly skilled at this bar trick, you will be able to replace the paper between the two shot glasses and remove the bourbon and put it back on the bar. Note: make sure the opening between the glasses is very small. A large opening will cause the water and alcohol to mix. Bar trick number 10. Smoke on the water. Ingredients: 1 glass, a matchbook, 6 quarters, and an ashtray with water. Objective: get a free drink. Situation: bet your friends one drink that you can get the water out of the ashtray using only the ingredients mentioned without moving or tilting the ashtray. Solution: make sure ashtray is filled with at most a quarter inch of water. Stack the quarters in the center of the ashtray so the top two quarters are above the water. Place 4 unlit matches on top of the quarters. Light the matches and immediately cover the flame and quarters with the glass. The water will be drawn into the glass. Collect your bets. Bar trick number 11. The wish in a bottle. Ingredients: 1 newly emptied bottle of Grand Marnier, a matchbook, a cork, a straw, and a sword cocktail pit. Objective: to play with fire while making a wish. Situation: get your friends to make a wish. Tell them if the sword sticks in the ceiling, then their wish will come true. Solution: take a newly emptied Grand Marnier bottle and put a cork in it. Place the bottle under hot water for about 10 minutes. While the bottle is heating, take a straw and bend it in half. Take your sword pick and stick it through the fold in the straw. The straw should be folded back over the handle of the sword pick. When the bottle is ready, carefully remove the cork so the heated gas in the bottle does not escape. Quickly put the straw and the sword in the bottle with the tip of the sword pick pointing out the opening of the bottle. Make a wish and drop a match in the bottle. Warning: there will be a large flame and the straw and the sword pick will be forced out of the bottle. Keep your face and others away from the opening. If the straw sticks in the ceiling, then your wish comes true. If the straw does not stick, tell someone to buy you a drink for your troubles. If you do not get a flame, you have to buy everyone else drinks. Bar trick number 12. Blow the bottle. Ingredients: 1 empty beer bottle and a small piece of napkin. Objective: get a free drink. Situation: hold an empty beer bottle horizontally. Make sure inside of neck is dry. Tear off a small piece of napkin. Wad it up into a small ball. Place the napkin wad just inside the lip of the bottle. Hold the bottle in front of someone's face and bet them a drink that they cannot blow the napkin into the bottle. Solution: Bernoulli principle states that moving air has lower pressure than still air. Therefore, when your friend blows, the still air in the bottle will push the napkin out of the bottle, right back at the face of the blower. Note: the harder they blow, the faster the napkin will come out. If you get a really gullible person, you can have them try it again for a chance at another drink. You should be able to milk them for at least 3 or 4. A truly great bartender has some pretty funny jokes to share. Warning: some of these jokes may be rude, crude, raunchy, and controversial. Now, that's what makes a great bartender. Bar jokes. Did we forget to add that some of these jokes might also be bad? Oh well, try them on the drunk ones. They'll laugh anyway. First joke. 3 mice were sitting in a bar talking about how tough they were. The first mouse slams a shot and says, "I play with mouse traps for fun. I'll run into one on purpose, and as it's closing on me, I grab the bar and bench press it 20 or 30 times. And with that, he slams another shot. The second mouse slams a shot and says, "That's nothing. I take these decon tablets, cut them up, and snort them just for the fun of it." And with that, he slams another shot. The third mouse slams a shot, gets up and walks away. The first two mice look at each other and then turn to the third mouse and ask, "Where the hell are you going?" The third mouse stops and replies, "I'm going home to fuck the cat." Second joke. An Irishman, an Italian, and a Polish guy are in a bar. They are having a good time and all agree that the bar is a nice place. Then the Irishman says, "Aye, this is a nice bar. But where I come from back in Dublin, there's a better one. At McDougal's, you buy a drink, you buy another drink, and McDougal himself will buy your third drink." The others agree that sounds like a nice place. Then the Italian says, "Yeah, that's a nice bar, but where I come from, there's a better one. Over in Brooklyn, there's this place, Vinny's. At Vinny's, you buy a drink, Vinny buys you a drink. You buy another drink, Vinny buys you another drink." Everyone agrees, that sounds like a great bar. Then the Polish guy says, "You think that's great? Where I come from, there's this place, Warszawski's. At Warszawski's, they buy you your first drink, then you buy your second drink, then they buy you your third drink, and then they take you in the back and get you laid." "Wow," said the other two, "that's fantastic. Did that actually happen to you?" "No," he replied, "but it happened to my sister." Third joke. One day, a bar owner decided he had had enough of the slow business and needed a gimmick. He finally decided on one. He got a horse and put it in the bar. He placed a sign over the horse and had the sign read, "Pay $100, make the horse laugh, win $1,000. For years, the gimmick worked. Finally, a man walked into the bar and saw the sign and asked, "Is that sign for real?" The bar owner told him it was. The man paid $100, walked up to the horse, and whispered something to the horse. The horse started to laugh, falling to his knees. The next day, the owner changed the sign. "Pay $100, make the horse cry, win $1,000. For years, the gimmick worked. One day, the same man walked into the bar and saw the sign. He paid the owner $100 and asked for a curtain. The man closed the curtain and then opened it a couple of moments later. The horse was now crying up a storm. The man walked up to the bar owner and asked for his money. "Not so fast," the bar owner said. "First, you have to tell me what you did both times." "Simple," said the man. "First, I told him I was bigger. This time, I proved it." Fourth joke. An Irishman walks into a bar in Dublin, orders 3 pints of Guinness, and sits in the back of the room, drinking a sip out of each one in turn. When he finishes them, he comes back to the bar and orders 3 more. The bartender asks him, "You know, a pint goes flat after I draw it. It would taste better if you bought one at a time." The Irishman replies, "Well, you see, I have 2 brothers. One is in America, the other is in Australia, and I'm here in Dublin. When we all left home, we promised that we'd drink this way to remember the day when we drank together." The bartender admits that this is a pretty nice custom and leaves it there. The Irishman becomes a regular in the bar and always drinks the same way. He orders 3 pints and drinks them in turn. One day he comes in and orders 2 pints. All the other regulars notice and fall silent. When he comes back to the bar for the second round, the bartender says, "I don't want to intrude on your grief, but I wanted to offer my condolences on your great loss." The Irishman looks confused for a moment. Then a light dawns in his eye and he laughs. "Oh no," he says, "everyone's fine. I've just quit drinking." Fifth joke. 2 blokes are in a bar on top of the Empire State Building. One says to the other, "You know, if you jump off this building, you get sucked in at the 10th floor. The other one laughs and says, "No way, man, prove it." The first guy agrees, and they both go to the edge. He jumps off and woof, he gets sucked in at the 10th floor. When he gets back to the top, the second guy, standing in shock, says, "I don't believe it. Let me try." So the second guy jumps off, and splat, he falls to his death. The first guy goes back to the bar. When he gets there, the bartender toots and says, "You know, Superman, you can be a real bastard when you're drunk." Sixth joke. After a beer festival in London, all the brewery presidents decided to go out for a beer. Corona's president sits down and says, "Señor, I would like the world's best beer, a Corona." The bartender takes a bottle from the shelf and gives it to him. Then Budweiser's president says, "I'd like the best beer in the world. Give me the king of beers, a Budweiser." The bartender gives him one. Coors' president says, "I'd like the best beer in the world, the only one made with Rocky Mountain spring water. Give me a Coors." He gets it. The guy from Guinness sits down and says, "Give me a Coke." The other brewery presidents look over at him and ask, "Why aren't you drinking a Guinness?" And the Guinness president replies, "Well, if you guys aren't drinking beer, neither will I." Seventh joke. A Scotsman is sitting in a bar in Cuba and is minding his own business when a man with a large black beard walks in. The man goes to the bar and orders a shot of whiskey. The bartender serves him. The man drinks the whiskey and then starts walking out the door. The bartender says, "Hey, aren't you going to pay for that?" The man says, "Excuse me, Castro's army." The bartender says, "All right then." And the man leaves. A few minutes later, another man with a large black beard walks in. The man goes to the bar and orders a shot of whiskey. The bartender serves him. The man drinks the whiskey and then starts walking out the door. The bartender says, "Hey, aren't you going to pay for that?" The man says, "Excuse me, Castro's army." The bartender says, "All right then." And the man leaves. The Scotsman gets an ID and walks up to the bar and orders a shot of whiskey. He drinks the whiskey and then starts walking out the door. The bartender says, "Hey, aren't you going to pay for that?" The Scotsman says, "Excuse me, Castro's army." The bartender says, "Hey, where's your big black beard?" The Scotsman thinks quickly. He lifts his kilt and says, "Secret Service." Eighth joke. A businessman enters a tavern, sits down at the bar, and orders a double martini on the rocks. After he finishes the drink, he peeks inside his shirt pocket, then orders the bartender to prepare another double martini. After he finishes that, he again peeks inside his shirt pocket and orders the bartender to bring another double martini. The bartender says, "Look, buddy, I'll bring you martinis all night long, but you gotta tell me why you look inside your shirt pocket before you order a refill." The customer replies, "I'm peeking at a photo of my wife. When she starts to look good, I know it's time to go home." Ninth joke. A new guy in town walks into a bar and reads a sign that hangs over the bar. Free beer for the person who can pass the test. So the guy asks the bartender what the test is. Bartender replies, "Well, first you have to drink that whole gallon of pepper tequila, the whole thing at once, and you can't make a face while doing it. Second, there's a gator out back with a sore tooth. You have to remove it with your bare hands. Third, there's a woman upstairs who's never had an orgasm. You gotta make things right for her." The guy says, "Well, as much as I would love free beer, I won't do it. You have to be nuts to drink a gallon of pepper tequila and then get crazier from there." Well, as time goes on, the man drinks a few beer. He said, "Where's that tequila?" He grabs the gallon of tequila with both hands and downs it with a big slurp and tears streaming down his face. Next, he staggers out back, and soon all the people inside hear the most frightening roaring and thumping, then silence. The man staggers back into the bar, his shirt ripped and big scratches all over his body. "Now," he says, "where's that woman with the sore tooth?" Tenth joke. One night, a police officer was stalking out a particularly rowdy bar for possible violations of the driving under the influence laws. At closing time, he saw a fellow stumble out of the bar, trip on the curb, and try his keys on 5 different cars before he found his. Then he sat in the front seat, fumbling around with his keys for several minutes. Everyone left the bar and drove off. Finally, he started his engine and began to pull away. The police officer was waiting for him. He stopped the driver, read him his rights, and administered the breathalyzer test. The results showed a reading of 0.0. The puzzled officer demanded to know how that could be. The driver replied, "Tonight, I'm the designated decoy." Now it's time for the responsible part. How to know when enough is enough. Many people think that alcohol is good. Often, in certain doses, it is. But there comes a time when you have to tell someone, "No more." They won't be happy. You won't be popular anymore. But they'll thank you in the morning. Well, maybe the morning after that. But still, it's important for you to help your friends or customers realize that when it's time to stop, it's time to stop. Here are some telltale signs. Speech is slurred. When "another drink, please" sounds like "another drink, please," it's time to stop. The person who can no longer stand without the aid of a prop. To test this theory, kneel down behind the bar quickly, then come back up. If the patron is on the floor, it's time to stop. When he or she tells you they love you more than twice, it's time to stop. Sure, they love you tonight, but will they respect you in the morning? When their bar tab looks like the working yearly budget of a small country, it's time to stop. Unless you're serving Donald Trump, cut him off. Of course, if you're serving Donald Trump, call me. If anyone starts dancing on the bar, it's time to stop. Even if it's the hot chick who's been flirting with you all night long, or the long-retired Chippendale dancer, the show won't be worth the consequences. No, really, it won't. If anyone insists they can drive, it's time to stop. Sober people don't feel the need to justify their abilities to handle a motor vehicle. Drunken people do. Cut them off and find them a friend to drive them home. If you're having a party in your home, With you as the bartender, here are some party safety tips. Don't serve alcohol to someone under the legal drinking age. Check identification. Don't allow the serving of alcohol to or consumption of alcohol by those without proper identification. Keep the number of guests at a manageable number. Avoid violations of occupancy limits. Don't allow uninvited guests to crash the party. Don't let guests mix their own drinks. Choose a reliable bartender who will help keep track of the size and number of drinks guests consume. Remember that beer can be just as intoxicating as hard liquor. A 12-ounce can of beer, a 5-ounce glass of wine, and a 12-ounce wine cooler contain the same amount of alcohol and the same intoxication potential as an ounce and a half of liquor. Prepare plenty of foods so guests will not drink on empty stomachs. Avoid salty foods, which make people thirsty, and drink more. Monitor outside activities. Don't allow guests to carry open containers of alcohol in public areas. Don't allow guests to park their vehicles illegally. Be a good neighbor. Keep music, people noise, and trash litter levels at a minimum. Clean outside litter immediately after the party. Ask boisterous or rude guests to leave. One such guest can ruin the party for others. Offer a variety of non-alcoholic beverages for the designated driver and/or for those who prefer not to drink. Do not push drinks. Drinking at a party is not mandatory for having a good time. Close the bar 90 minutes before the party ends and serve non-alcoholic drinks or foods and coffee. Remember, though, only time sobers who are intoxicated. Politely but firmly tell intoxicated guests that you cannot let them drive home because you care. Arrange for designated drivers to taxi partygoers to their destination. Become familiar with signs of alcohol poisoning and treatment. Cooperate with police. They are usually there because someone has complained. A spirit of cooperation will help in reducing the need for enforcement actions. For those of you thinking of bartending as a profession, here are a couple of tips for you. Going to the big show. There are bartending schools all over the country. A simple Google search will show you where the nearest one to you is. If you feel like spending a lot of money to learn what we've just told you about, by all means, go right ahead. However, most local bars won't care if you've gone to bartending university. On-the-job training is the best. But a basic knowledge will help you along the way. We do have a few suggestions to help you along the way. Welcome all of your customers as though you know them, and introduce yourself. Remember their names and welcome them. Remember their names and welcome them, using their names, the next time they visit. Keep a legal pad if you need to. Gray beard, thick glasses, name George, drinks Bud, and any quirks you can note that will help you recall. Failing that, just say, "Hey, good to see you again." Just think of it like you are having a party in your own home. It's easy. Always keep in mind what their drink of choice is and be prepared to offer them their preference. You should already know the names and preferences of your regulars. If a customer comes accompanied by a date or companion, treat them both as if they are royalty. Address the customer as in, "Wonderful to see you again, Mr. or Miss So-and-so," if they are regular. "And what can I do especially for your guest?" Be sure to use the finest glass for their friend. If you treat them with that sort of respect, you can not only expect a nice tip, but you can bet that they will be back over and over and looking for you. Yes, do remember jokes. Remember them when you hear them and study them on the internet. Internet jokes are so boring that most of us just delete them, but the telling of a joke is just that. It is the delivery and the storytelling that makes it both interesting and amusing. Be prepared to have at least 2 new ones on every shift. Your smile and your obvious enjoyment of both your job and your customers are worth a lot more than tossing bottles about or doing circus tricks. If you can do it, well, it doesn't hurt, but most folks are there for a drink, company, and the respect and recognition they don't receive in day-to-day life. Depending on the policy of your employer, when customers come in for the first time and have just one beer while reading the newspaper or looking around, and then start to leave, slide them a free beer, drink, and say, "I'm glad that you came in, and I have enjoyed your company," calling them by name, of course. "My name is so-and-so, and please come back. Pay for that beer or drink out of your tips if you must. You will get it back tenfold." Remember that these are customers. They are not really your buddies, so stay professional. Though you will have many opportunities for intimate encounters, stay focused on your career and that you are there to make a living. Don't ever forget that one-night stands are never just that in the bartending world. The customer you became close with will likely be sitting on the other side of the bar within a few days, regardless of how much you regret that moment. If there is trouble or violence, try at all costs to avoid coming up from behind the bar. Raise your voice and attempt to take control verbally while you are dialing 911. Tip jars are sort of an optional thing, depending on the